Like sprouts on your Jimmy John's sandwich, you won't be able to get them for the foreseeable future. The FDA issued the restaurant chain a warning letter saying their sprouts and cucumbers were involved in 5 E. coli outbreaks in the last 7 years. The letter also gave the chain 15 days to respond to how they're going to fix the problem. We reached out to Jimmy John's. They didn't want to go on camera, but they made a statement saying food safety is our top priority. We've removed sprouts from all Jimmy John's restaurants until further notice.
Jimmy John's, a true American food brand that for over 40 years has been serving, delivering, and being an overall role model in the fast food and restaurant market at large, especially compared to what their arch competitors were up to. However, not even Jimmy John's is safe from controversy. As a matter of fact, that brings us into discussion of this video, as we discuss Jimmy John's odd history of recalls. Being founded on the day of January 13th of 1983 by a man named Jimmy John Liatude, it was often reported that in Jimmy's early life, living in the harsh city of Chicago, Illinois, while attending the high-end Eline Academy School in Illinois, it was reported from classmates, teachers, and higher-ups from the school that Jimmy was not the best of students, reportedly skipping class constantly to smoke and drink while in school. It's clear, Jimmy had quite the problems, especially in school. However, just as things looked bleak for Jimmy, such as exploitation and not graduating, Jimmy John's Dean of Discipline believed in him and worked hard to keep him in school. And thankfully, it worked out for both Jimmy John and his Dean of Discipline. Because come 1982, Jimmy John had graduated second to last in his class, but regardless, had passed. However, with graduating, Jimmy was unsure on what to do with his life. College wasn't a good option due to his overall poor performance and record in his academy school. And while also barely passing as it was, it's clear Jimmy was in quite the life predicament. However, thankfully for him, it would not remain that way for long, because with a whopping $25,000 deal from his father to start his own business. But on the other hand, if Jimmy was unable to do so, he would have no choice but to go down a similar path in his father's life and join the army. But with it, Jimmy accepted the deal from his father. But after a failed endeavor into the hot dog market, Jimmy soon realized how hard it would be to truly start a business, from buying / leasing a building to just the cost of the equipment. It's clear that Jimmy had quite a lot on his plate just to figure out. However, while Jimmy was eating at a sub shop one day, he had noticed the simplicity and non-too-complex technology that was in use at the sub shop. We're following, after months of research and study, the sub industry overall. Jimmy had made the jump at the beginning of the year in January of 1983, starting what would go down into infamy to be known as Jimmy John's, or at the time, what would be called World's Greatest Sandwiches. And from there, food history was made, and over the course of 37 years, Jimmy would only continue to grow and grow his brand all throughout the United States, where come 2020, having around a whopping over 20,000 locations were reported to be all around the USA. But much to the dismay of the entire world, a certain sickness was on the rise that would eventually wreak havoc all throughout the world, and this sickness would go down into history to be known as
COVID-19, the disease that defined our lives in 2020.
2020 is now the deadliest year in U.S. history.
Since late March, the U.S. has led the world with the most cases and the most deaths, now at more than 334,000. What began as a faraway outbreak in China.
There is growing concern at this hour over a possible outbreak of a mystery virus.
Whenever we hear this is new, we haven't seen this before, we have no history on this pathogen, hairs stand on edge.
Tonight authorities confirm it is being spread from human to human.
During the beginning months of 2020, while the COVID-19 virus was on the rise, causing fear and anguish all throughout the world, the Jimmy John's brand was dealing with their own controversy during this time, when in February of 2020, the FDA would reveal that a sprout outbreak caused by E. coli 0103, a bacteria often found and attracted in fruit and vegetable foods that can cause symptoms like stomach cramps, diarrhea, that can often be bloody, cause vomiting, and extremely odd fevers, and a multitude of other sicknesses that E. coli 0103 might cause. But as it would soon be revealed, throughout the years, Jimmy John's was dealing with this major E. coli problem, and it would all start back in 2008, when it was reported that 28 Colorado University students were sickened when in contact with E. coli, having all symptoms associated with the bacterial sickness, where it was revealed that a common denominator of the sickenings was Jimmy John's restaurants in the Boulder and Adams County part of Colorado, where it was discovered from Colorado's Health Department of Investigation Unit that multiple Jimmy John's workers were infected with E. coli, as well as several broken health regulations that was going on with Jimmy John's in the Colorado border Adams County part of America, such as poor hand washing and overall not good food preparation practices that was in use. And that brings us into the next year, when in February of 2009, it was reported in Nebraska from the Nebraska Department of Health and Human Service officials that 256 people were sickened in connection to a common strain of salmonella, when it was originally reported that 6 cases of salmonella sickenings occurred, and in 2008, it was as well reported that multiple subtype strains of salmonella was detected and identified throughout the USA, were eventually reaching Nebraska the following year, and with it, as mentioned, come 2009, would go on to sicken 256 people, with it being reported to be traced back to the city of Omaha, Nebraska, when 42 of those 256 sickenings would occur in that city alone, dating to around March 15th of 2009. And with it, the Jimmy John's brand was yet again linked to sickenings, but unlike last time, it was reported that the outbreak occurred in a Sprouts factory that, in turn, when shipped out, caused the salmonella to contaminate the Jimmy John's restaurants. Moving forward, over a year later, in December of 2010, it was reported from the Illinois Department of Health that on December 17th, an investigation was underway into multiple reports of a salmonella outbreak occurring with the salmonella subserotype 4512 variant was reportedly sickening Illinois residents across the state that totaled to have sickened 140 people, wherewith investigation from the Illinois Department of Health reported that Tiny Green Organic Farms, a farming company that is located in Illinois, had been discovered that a lot of Western County, Illinois farms had been contaminated with the Salmonella serotype outbreak, where in turn, the sprouts and vegetables were shipped all throughout Jimmy John's locations all throughout the state of Illinois. Where in turn, with a suspicious rise of sickenings across Illinois, the FDA got involved to investigate and figure out what was occurring across the state. And come January of 2011, on the 14th, it was discovered that multiple Illinois farms associated with Tiny Green's brand were discovered to be carrying and shipping out the Salmonella serotype bacteria. And with it, was discovered that multiple Illinois Jimmy John's were spreading and infecting people with the Salmonella serotype bacteria. And with it, the FDA would put up a warning involving Jimmy John's Sprouts products to not put it on your sandwich and or just outright avoid Jimmy John's as a whole. But going back to the Illinois Sprout Farm, the FDA would reveal that several FDA inspections that had been conducted had been revealed that due to poor cleaning and maintenance practices that primarily led to the contamination of the Sprout factories, such as water from test and practices used at all Sprouts farms all throughout the state of Illinois. And soon following, this constant rise in cases involving Jimmy John's Sprouts products, the owner of Jimmy John's brand, Jimmy John Latitude, had taken off the Sprout item off of the menu, at least for the time, due to by this point, the unpredictability of these outbreaks occurring involving Jimmy John's restaurants. However, all the way across the country, in Kent, Washington, it was reported that 7 people were sickened in connection with the Salmonella serotype bacteria around 2010, before the temporary Sprouts brand was in effect. And with it, investigation from the FDA could 100% confirm that Kent, Washington area Jimmy John's were indeed infecting people with the Salmonella serotype bacteria. With it being reported that a recall of Sprouts products, especially involving Jimmy John's brand, were occurring, and with it, a recall process begun. Moving forward 2 years in 2012, it was reported that from multiple states that a total of 29 individuals were infected with an outbreak strain of E. coli 026, especially on the eastern part of the United States, where the vast majority of sickenings were occurring. And the 23 of those 27 sickenings were reported to be directly from the Jimmy John's brand. It was as well reported that the age range of these sickenings were from the ages of 9 to 57 years old. And just 2 years after the last big Jimmy John's outbreak involving Sprouts had once again occurred. And yet again, with the FDA getting involved on how another Jimmy John's outbreak yet again occurred, and this time, multiple sprouting facilities reported to be contaminated with E. coli 026, with results of traceback from Clover Sprouts at Jimmy John's restaurants were likely the cause of this outbreak, And come the 2014 to through 2019 time era, reports of salmonella and E. coli sickenings were still occurring in connection with the Jimmy John's brand. So by this point, it was becoming very clear that the Jimmy John's company had a very notable outbreak problem plaguing their restaurants all throughout the years. And come the most unholy year of the millennium, 2020, the most notable outbreak to date would occur, with it being reported that 51 people were infected with yet again E. coli 0103 outbreak across over the course of 10 states. But unlike the past times, the FDA accused Jimmy John's of intentionally serving food linked with the E. coli bacteria, with it as well being reported from the CDC that the primarily illness dates of the bacteria outbreak would have started around the January 6th to March 15th of 2020 time era. And all things considered, it's very strange looking and even researching Jimmy John's past recalls and just how connected they are all together. But with the FDA stepping up and getting heavily involved in developing and what they call a strategic blueprint on how to use all available resources, techniques, and technologies on how to stop foodborne illnesses under the Food Safety Modernization Act, a major reform law that is focused on preventing and stopping contaminated food of all kind. So there you have it, Jimmy John's odd history of recalls. Unlike other recalls we've looked into, it's very strange how Jimmy John's has consistently dealt with contamination of their sprout and veggie products, and how cases have just repeatedly popped up throughout the years like that. But with that, I've been Skipperson, and I hope you all have a great day.